Hi, everybody. I'm Heather Dawson. Every week on our show, we bring you the best of California. So let's start off with a tour of headlines that made news around the state.
Hi, California Live. We are Wildlife Connection. We are located in Puerto Vallarta, and we invite you to come and enjoy dolphins in the wild.
This is Ilana. I'm Marco. We are Travelarios. And we're bringing you with us as we explore Puerto Vallarta.
We're heading out on the Banderas Bay with Wildlife Connection for a close encounter experience where we'll have the amazing opportunity to swim with wild bottlenose dolphins with professional biologists as our guides.
We began the program as a research program and just as a while watching dolphins, not swimming with them since 98. As I mentioned, it has been a process, dolphins knowing us and we knowing the dolphins in a way that now we can have a program that we can be with them. They feel comfortable with us around and it can be enjoyable for us and for the dolphins.
Swimming alongside wild dolphins is a once in a lifetime experience. And our professional guides made sure we experienced a safe environment with these majestic creatures.
It is very safe. We never had an accident with them because they're on their own habitat and they know they're more powerful than us. Actually, they don't feel comfortable with us, they move away. And I trust enough on them because I sent my kid on the water with dolphins and she was swimming with them since she was 3 years old. That gives you an idea. Is perfectly safe for everyone.
Wildlife Connection primarily conducts research which can only be studied in the wild. And with all this information, they hope to promote the species protection in Banderas Bay.
What we would like to do is to protect them in here, especially because it has developed a lot. There are many boats, there are jet skis, and there have been accidents with that. It's hard to push the government to put certain rules against those activities. Not that they cannot do that, just if you see a dolphin, please don't speed or something to protect the dolphins in here because they're resident animals.
They also offer the opportunity to visit a turtle camp where baby marine turtles are released every night. And anyone is able to participate and support in the conservation of marine turtles.
As you can see, we use red lights because we don't want to be really invasive with the animals. The red light is not affecting her. She doesn't feel uncomfortable with that. And it gives us a very good visibility.
For more information and to book one of the many Echo Tours with the Wildlife Connection, visit their website, wildlifeconnection.com.
So stay with us on California Life as Ilana and I continue exploring Puerto Vallarta.
And turning now to the friendly skies, Wes Parker takes us to the Burbank Airport to see some living history. Hang on tight for this wild ride in the latest segment of The Good Life.
Hello everyone, it's Wes Parker once again for The Good Life, and today I'm at Burbank Airport where we have three vintage World War II airplanes. And the big surprise is very soon I will be going up in the air in a vintage P-51 Mustang fighter.
The B-17, B-24, and the P-51 on display all played an important role in America's victory in World War II. And even celebrities like Tom Hanks and Jay Leno have gotten in on the action. The airplanes are on display as a part of the 20th season of the Wings of Freedom Tour, organized by the Collings Foundation, an organization dedicated to preserving and celebrating these special aircraft. The tour provides an opportunity for people to be a part of living history by exploring and even flying in these vintage warplanes. It also gives veterans like Charles Norm Stevens a chance to come and share their stories with a captive audience.
I loved that airplane from the first moment I saw it. That was my dream, to be a bombardier on a plane like this, and I did accomplish that.
Norm Stevens grew up in Englewood and was still just a teenager when he became a part of the 351st Bomb Group, responsible for flying raids over Germany.
You have written a book, Norm, about your experiences, which you have here in your hands.
Right. This is called An Innocent Pole Brook. And I call it innocent at Paul Brook because I was only 19 years old, didn't know much about anything at that time. So I was the innocent one, and Paul Brook was the name of the field from which we flew. And this contains a record of all of the 34 bombing missions that I was on, plus our leaves and many of the thoughts that I had about what was happening to me and my loneliness for home. It's all in here.
The Collings Foundation provides history and aviation fans a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity by allowing them to actually go up in the air with seasoned pilots for an experience they'll never forget.
But I'm going to show you some acrobatics. We're going to go upside down and back over like that, and we'll go fast, and we'll go low, and thoroughly enjoy the fine feel of this aircraft. You'll love the sound and the feel of the Rolls-Royce Merlin B-12 pulling us along. It's like a locomotive with wings.
For California Life, this is Wes Parker bringing you The Good Life.
And Wes joins us now on set. Wes, that looked amazing.
It looked amazing. I was so looking forward to this, Heather. I really was. I wanted to get up in a fighter plane. I've never done it. When I was a little kid, P-51s and P-38s were flying over our house, and I would jump up and down, and the sound of the engines was that Rolls-Royce, beautiful, smooth sound. And then when I got on the plane, I realized, wait a minute, I'm 6'2", and this plane was built for somebody 5'5".
Wow, so it was snug.
It was too snug. They put a parachute on me, and there were five straps that locked me in. I could not move. I didn't get to steer the plane, which I really wanted to do once we got up there. But it was fun, and I have such admiration for these pilots who were in these stripped-down things that were just nothing more than war machines, no comfort.
Oh my! So was it really rocky when you're up there and loud and just like in the movies?
All of the above.
Mm-hmm. Oh, well, that's always exciting, though. At least you got to do it. You got to live your dream, and we really enjoyed your segment, and I know next time you're going and you're taking us to one of the ballparks here in California.
You will like that. You will love it.
Okay. Thanks, Wes. Always a pleasure to have you on set.
Thanks.
Welcome back. Our next guest is featured in People magazine for his innovative ideas that make every dad cool. After the birth of his first child, he found himself frustrated with the lack of dad-friendly baby accessories and decided to take matters into his own hands by creating a line of diaper bags for guys and a thriving website. He's been one of our favorite guests, and he's back in studio with us today. I'm pleased to welcome our California profile, Chris Pagula, the founder of Diaper Dude. So nice to see you again,
Chris.
It's
great to see you. Thanks for having me back.
Yes, and we've been busy. We both now have three children.
Yes, that's right.
And a lot of new developments with Diaper Dude.
Yeah, we were excited about this year because we launched a line of eco-friendly products this year. Specifically, I have with me our Messenger 2 bag. So this is a little more sophisticated of a bag compared to our original design. And it's made of recycled PET fabric. So it actually takes 25 16-ounce water bottles, plastic water bottles, to make this fabric. And so that's 25 less water bottles that are going to be in our landfills, which is pretty cool. And we've also have our pacifier pouches, a changing station, and insulated bottle holder that we use for this fabric as well.
And it looks very sleek.
Thanks.
I mean, let's face it, it's the guy pretty much that's carrying the diaper bag.
Absolutely, and we wanted to make sure again that we had a bag that doesn't look like a diaper bag. And we included actually our dad checklist as well, which is pretty cool
like
and fun.
That.
So you make sure you remember everything you need, especially baby, which is right there in the bottom.
So when you're loading up the cart, did you get this, did you get this?
Exactly, yeah, and we have a hidden compartment for dad in the back as well, so he can keep his personal items separate from babies, so you have more storage for yourself too. So you can use it for the laptop bag or anything else you'd like.
Well, I saw you in People again, so
thanks.
Congratulations.
Thanks.
And this is a great gift for baby showers, Father's
Absolutely.
Day.
Absolutely, and you know, we also launched a line of t-shirt sets that are a lot of fun for dad and baby. They have matching graphics on them and different sayings like, my kid totally rocks, my dad totally rocks, and hardcore daddy, hardcore baby. So those are really cool. And they come in a great gift packaging too, so it's ready to go and give as a gift.
And what about your website?
The website's really cool. We actually have a whole interactive part of it, a section called Ask the Dude, where different people can walk right in and ask questions, whether it deals with gear, travel, parenting, or whatever it is. And it's a lot of fun to have feedback from people out there about our product and what it's like to be a dad today.
Do you wish you had something like that when you were starting out?
I do.
That's why you did this, right?
Absolutely, yeah. It's actually refreshing now to hear other people feeling like the same boat that you were when you started out. And it's actually cool to be able to relate the experience and knowledge that I have from being a dad three times over. And, you know, it's just a lot of fun.
Well, you've had, I mean, quite the success, and you've had a lot of celebrities, too.
Yeah, we've been fortunate that we've had a number of celebrities associated with our product, and that's what we're all about.
All right. Always a pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
It's the season that strikes fear in even the most calm, cool, and collected folks. We're talking about tax time. And a NerdWallet and Harris poll reveals 69% of people fear filing taxes. However, being in the know should help ease that anxiety. Topping the list this season, possible refund delays.
There are about 30 million taxpayers who are affected by the Protecting Americans Against Tax Hikes Act. It requires the IRS to hold the entire refund of anyone claiming the earned income tax credit or the additional child tax credit until at least February 15th. It could even cause some delays until the week of February 27th.
But Jennifer Owens, a master tax advisor, says there is a solution to help prevent further delays.
For taxpayers who would like access to money faster than the IRS can provide a refund, H&R Block is now offering the refund advance, where you can get an advance on your refund of up to $1,250 after filing your taxes. It's a no-interest loan from MetaBank, and it's paid back once your refund is received. It's currently available at participating H&R Block offices for a limited time.
Here's something to bank on, ways to maximize your money you may not be aware of. Claim any major life changes like marriage, having a baby, or buying a home. Make sure you're claiming the correct filing status because it affects your credits and deductions. And consider itemizing.
One in three taxpayers itemize when millions more actually can. Essentially, if you pay mortgage interest, if you pay property taxes, real estate taxes, or you even make charitable contributions, you should consider itemizing deductions to help lower your taxable income.
And if you didn't carry health insurance last year, there are about 24 exemptions that can help erase or minimize the penalty. For more helpful tax tips, check out hrblock.com/refundadvance.
Nearly 40 new models, including world and North American debuts, are on display here at the 2017 North American International Auto Show in Detroit. One of the big debuts is this Batmobile made out of Legos in the Chevrolet display. It was popular among the kids and also the adults on public days. The car was shown to promote the upcoming Lego Batman movie, coming to theaters on February 10th.
Completely amazing, because it took them a really long time to do it, and look how huge it is.
The Volkswagen ID Buzz microbus concept drew lots of attention during press days. It's an electric vehicle that is fully capable of driving on its own. In fact, the front seats can spin around to face the rear passengers.
You know, all the vehicles from all the manufacturers, the new Camry will be a car that's a real staple car here in the U.S. So to me, and some of the Ford products, the new Mustang that they've had and the upgrades will be terrific, give us a chance to sell those in the dealerships.
Behind me is the Chrysler Portal minivan. It was designed for and by millennials, and it came straight from CES in Las Vegas. The Portal offers an electric range of 250 miles. And dozens of tech-savvy features inside. You guessed it, the Portal also offers some self-driving capabilities.
It's a real bread and butter show. You're seeing a lot of sport utility vehicles, and that's what people are interested in. These are vehicles that get a lot better fuel economy than SUVs from the past.
Kia showed off its all-new Stinger midsize sedan. It will come with a 2.0-liter turbocharged engine, producing 255 horsepower. Ford Motor Company announced that it will begin offering a diesel version of its best-selling F-150 pickup truck. In addition, the automaker said it would bring back the Ranger small pickup in 2019 and the Bronco SUV in 2020. Behind me is the Chevrolet Bolt EV, this year's pick for the North American Car of the Year. In the lower level of Cobo Center, the University of Michigan showed off a self-driving Lincoln Continental. It's outfitted with front-facing cameras, radar, and sensors. M-City is a 32-acre full-scale urban environment being used to test autonomous vehicles on the University of Michigan's North Campus.
We're now well in the midst of this year's award season, and we can say one thing for sure. There's been one movie which dominated it from the very beginning.
And the Golden Globe goes to...
La La Land.
But here we go, La La Land.
2016 Gross People's Choice Award goes to Damien Chazelle's La La Land.
Emma Stone, La La Land.
Ryan Gosling, La La Land.
Yes, La La Land, the love story musical, A Day to Los Angeles, starring Ryan Gosling and Emma Stone, has garnered so far 179 nominations and won no less than 105 awards, including 8 Critics' Choice Movie Awards and 7 Golden Globes. There's no doubt in anyone's mind that La La Land will be nominated for Academy Awards, yet it is not yet certain that other movies in the race won't spoil its potential sweep on February 26. Let's not forget last year's debacle with hashtag OscarSoWhite campaign on Twitter, which dominated last year's awards. This year, Academy voters will for sure take note not to vote too white, and with a number of stellar African-American themed flicks, which include, amongst others, Moonlight, Loving, Fences, and Hidden Figures, the variety to choose from is far from being limited.
Let me ask you, if you were a white male, would you wish to be an engineer?
I wouldn't have to. I'd already be one.
Now let's look at the frontrunners of this year's award season. For Best Actor, the frontrunner is Ryan Gosling for La La Land. Yet there is also Casey Affleck for Manchester by the Sea, Andrew Garfield for Hacksaw Ridge, and Tom Hanks for Sully. The frontrunner for the Best Actress category is Emma Stone for La La Land, yet spoilers potentially might come from Natalie Portman for Jackie, Amy Adams for Arrival, and Isabelle Huppert for Elle. In the Best Supporting Actor category, the most talked about name is Marcella Ali for Moonlight. Yet, there's also Lucas Hedges for Manchester by the Sea, Jeff Bridges for Hell and High Water, and Dev Patel for Lion. In the Supporting Actress category, it is Viola Davis' time to win an Oscar for her role in Fences, although don't disregard completely Michelle Williams for Manchester by the Sea, Naomi Harris for Moonlight, and Nicole Kidman for Lion. In the Director category, it really is La La Land's Damien Chazelle's award to beat, but we all know until they open the envelope on stage, everything is a possibility, so other serious contenders in that category are Barry Jenkins for Moonlight, Kenneth Lonergan for Manchester by the Sea, and Denzel Washington for Fences. And finally, Best Picture is also a La La Land shoo-in, yet spoilers could come from Moonlight or even Fences, both African-American themed movies. There are many deserving performances in the 339 movies which were eligible for awards consideration. However, it will be a huge shame, in my mind, that La La Land won't become immortalized in cinematic history with winning the Academy Awards. California Life, I'm Ron Jacobson.
And that's it for us. If you missed any part of our show, go to our website, californialivehd.com. See you next time.
Watch us on our YouTube channel. Stay connected to our social media, like our blogs on Facebook. Follow our tweets on Twitter. And check out our posts on Instagram and Pinterest, where we bring you the best of California.